But I want to just take a pause for a minute and jump out of that conversation and go back to very briefly what we were talking about yesterday. You remember 10 New Jersey lawmakers, 9 Democrats, 1 Republican, took a trip to Cuba that Vincent Prieto, the Speaker of the Assembly, said was unauthorized. We heard from some folks that were opposed, some that went on the trip. And now I'm joined by Dr. Felix Roque. He is the mayor of West New York, also Cuban born, and very upset about the trip that New Jersey lawmakers took to Cuba last week. Dr. Roque, good morning, and thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Good morning, and thank you for having me on the radio this morning.
Yeah, you bet. So, all right, Felix, you gotta tell me. First of all, give me a little bit of background. You're Cuban-American. What is your story coming out of Cuba? And then what did this trip mean to you and the Cuban-Americans in New Jersey, which I understand this is the second highest concentration of Cuban-Americans in the country outside of Florida?
That it is. I actually came from Cuba in 1967. I was about 11 years old. And the reason I came is not that I wanted to come. It's a very oppressive regime. You have no liberties, no rights. My dad was a doctor. We were very well off. And that's basically what kept me from going and cutting sugarcane on the weekends. Because these people are really not nice people, the way they handle the community there.
Mm-hmm.
Again, there's no freedom of speech. There's nothing. So we immigrated in 1967. I came to this country, and I've done very well. I served the military 36 years and retired recently. I became the mayor. This is my second term. I got 3 more years. God bless America. But I'm going to tell you, the whole trip was a very unfortunate thing.
Tell me why.
I'll tell you, because they're like Boy Scouts going in and fighting in a battlefield. They didn't know what they were getting into, and the Castro regime has a very good propaganda machine. And they were misquoted, and I feel bad for them because they didn't know what they were going into, and they got misquoted and misrepresented.
But Felix, these are smart people. I mean, Holly Schapese was the Republican who some have talked about her on the short list of potentially running for governor. Reed Gusciora, one of the smartest guys in the legislature. I have to believe they knew exactly what they were going and getting into.
They didn't know the landscape, my opinion, and they didn't know how manipulative the Castro regime is with the propaganda. And they empowered the Castro regime by their mere presence there. That's what they did, and right now the Cuban community is in an uproar here in Union City in West New York, and it wasn't the right thing to do. They should have got some guidance. You know, they have Senator Menendez, who's an expert in this.
What do you say when, and I asked Reed Gusciora this yesterday, and he said, look, there are two reasons in his mind. One, given the context of the recent snowstorm, he said, you know, if we get this embargo lifted, the purchase of salt from the salt mines in Cuba is going to reduce the cost to New Jersey taxpayers. And two, he brought up a medical advancement that would prevent amputations with people that are afflicted with diabetes. He said there's a medical breakthrough that they had in Cuba that we don't have available here because of the embargo. Now, I'm not a medical expert, and I'm certainly not a salt mine expert. But when he right when he said it, I think to the average person, it's like, oh, that makes sense. What do you say to that?
I'm a medical expert. I'm actually a doctor. My specialty is pain management. Listen, I'm sure there's a lot of developments, and I'm sure we could get a lot of things from Cuba. But the reality is the Cuban countrymen are living under an oppressive regime where there's no democracy, there is no elections. There's people in jails because they wanted to express their freedom. And what I say is, what are we getting in return? Nothing. If you think about it, they want us to give them back Guantanamo and open the exchange. But for what? They still have the cop killer, Chesnar, there. They still treat people like garbage over there. There's no liberties.
You know, one person suggested that, and actually this has come up a few times, saying that even lifting the embargo is not a good idea, because what will happen is, because the communist regime controls everything, there's no private property, there's no, you know, the means of production, all of the shops and any warehouse, any manufacturing, all controlled by the government. All you would do then is empower the guys that are suppressing the opposition even more.
That is exactly what basically they did by going over there. They actually empowered the Castro regime just by being there. And that wasn't the right move. In my opinion, fortunate that they did that, but it wasn't a good move on their part. And what we should do is, you know, demand from the Castro regime what we want, not what he wants. And that's how we should negotiate.
So what are you going to do next? I understand that U.S. Senator Bob Menendez may be holding a press conference tomorrow. And I had Mayor Carlos Rendo on from Woodcliffe Lake yesterday. And he said there might be a press conference tomorrow. Is that happening? And will you be there?
I'm going to tell you, I didn't know about it, but of course I'm going to be there. And I'm a supporter of Senator Menendez and Congressman Alvio Sirius and Carlos Rendo. I know for many years he's a good man. Vinny Prieto, also the Speaker of the House, a fantastic individual. I know him since he was 11 years old.
He came from Cuba when he was 10. But why didn't he have a firmer stance on this? He seemed to just back off, don't you think?
I got a feeling he's a very honest and good man. I don't think he knew too much of what his people were doing.
Yeah.
And I don't think they asked for his permission. But listen, I just got back from Costa Rica. I spent 8 days with 7,000 Cuban refugees stranded there. And the reason they're stranded is only one reason. They're running away from the Castro regime.
Right.
They're not there because they want to come to America to look for a job. They're running away, and they're professionals, doctors, lawyers, engineers, people fleeing the oppression over
right.
there. So something is wrong with that picture, the reason we have so many Cubans coming in this direction.
So, all right, Dr. Roque, do me a favor. Can you get in touch with us tomorrow? I'd love to talk to you from the press conference. So I don't know if it's going to happen, you know, while I'm on the air, but if either way, I want to have this conversation again tomorrow. This is very important to the very high Cuban-American population in New Jersey.